Rashawn Patterson on stage performing their classics in front of a packed audience. It's going to be wonderful. We have an exclusive interview with both of them, both Niambi and Rashawn Patterson. So stay tuned to View Now TV to hear what these two artists have to say.
You can tell me anything you like, baby, you'll see me the same. Can't wait to get to the gym, cause oh how he rocks in shorts and white socks. But he doesn't know who I am.
And I'm about to go and speak to Temi Dollface. So let's go over.
Hello.
Hi, pleased to meet you.
Andrew.
Can we just have a quick introduction?
I'm Aaron.
I'm Temi Dollface.
I'm Roland.
Roland. Okay, we're going to find out all about you guys. First of all, I'd just like to know, for those that haven't, you know, heard your music before, how would you describe your style?
Well, I actually just put my music under the umbrella of drama soul, but I class myself as a multi-genre artist. It's just that my music is quite dramatic, but you'll just hear all my influences as a mishmash of hip-hop, R&B, soul, jazz, Afrobeat. I'm originally from Nigeria and I absolutely love Fela Kuti. He's been a huge inspiration, and so you'll hear that influence in my music. So it's a cross genre thing, I'd say, but I call it drama soul anyway.
Drama soul, that's very interesting. So where do you get your inspiration from to write your music?
Loads of things. I mean, it could be somebody says something that just sparks off an idea, or, you know, obviously a lot of it is about my life and things that I've gone through, things friends and family around me have gone through, or it could just be a movie that I watch that sparks off, you know, something interesting, something I read, a street sign, it could be anything.
So yeah. How quick is that creative process for you when you're writing?
Well, it really varies, it differs. Sometimes I can write a song in a day, all the ideas pour out. Sometimes I start with a chorus and I don't finish it till like 6 months later, when I'm a bit of a perfectionist that way. So the right punchline comes into my head and then I put it all together. But I generally start with a chord progression and the music kind of informs the words and, you know, the feeling. And then I take it from there, really.
Okay. Roland, yes. What is your part to play in the Temi Dollface?
produce her work, basically. We've been working together for about 3 years now. Yeah, so my brother and I, Aaron, we've been working together, putting her creativity into fusion.
Okay, so Temi Dollface has said that it's drama soul. Has it been drama in the studio trying to get that style?
Oh yes, loads of drama actually, but I think everything worked, when you hear music, you know, you can tell, you know, where the music basically is drama. What she's saying, the music actually tells the story, captures everything that she's saying. So yeah, it's been lots of drama in the studio and outside the studio as well. So.
But fun drama.
Fun drama, yes.
Fun drama. And yourself, is it Aaron?
Yes, Aaron.
Yes.
What's your part?
I produce as well. Yeah, as well. Co-producer and also help her with her vocal because I sing better than her.
Oh, okay. So
I'm just kidding.
That last, that whole last bit. Mm-hmm.
So we'll be getting an album from yourself as well, Aaron.
Yes, I've got some serious album coming out, but it's all about Tammy. So, I think I'm the drummer in the studio because I make her laugh. I make sure she's calm and everything, you know, goes according to plan and everything. We've known Tammy for a while, and this album has been a great, it has really inspired us to do great work, you know, and also we're looking forward for the completion.
Well, I have to say, I'm loving the outfit.
Thank you very much. Do you like the frills as well? I do.
You styled them as well. Excellent.
Apart from Merlin, Merlin's got his own. He's got his own look going on.
Okay. So, yeah. So I'm just thinking, where's the lenses for the glasses?
Invisible lens. It was designed by that Frenchman.
Okay.
But
tell me, what are you most known for? What song, you know, have people heard out there?
Well, I've been doing this for a while. I got signed to Sony some years ago, but, you know, I figured that, well, through my experiences, I realised that my creative freedom was most important to me, and being put in a mould just wasn't for me. So I started doing things on my own. And so the people that have been to some of my very few gigs know me best for a song called Exception to the Rule.
Exception to the rule. Yeah. And you also mentioned that Fela Kuti is your inspiration. I know most of his music is very political, driven. Is that...
It's not so much... That's not the part of his music that inspired me that much. Yes, I can completely relate to what he talks about, but I kind of talk more about love and other life experiences. Yeah, I probably will do a political song soon, but it's not really what I'm about, you know. But for me, it's the percussion, the fact that he's fused jazz with the African sound, and it just works so perfectly. And I can't explain what Fela's music does to me. I go out, and this African girl comes out of me that I didn't even know existed. I remember going to a tribute concert for him at Proud Galleries, and I just started doing these moves like the Fela dancers, and I'm like, who is this girl? I didn't recognize her, but it just does something to me, and it's amazing. It's, you know, so I've been playing around with that Afrobeat sound, and nowhere better to do it than go to Nigeria. I've been working with a producer out there as well. So it's all tying, you know, together quite well. And
excellent. Thank you very much, and thank you for your time.
Thank you very
Roland,
much.
Aaron, and of course Tammy Dolphy. Thank you very much.
It's been a pleasure.
Thank you.
Sugar, come on, it's time we go to bed. Darling, rest your weary aching head. Lay those burdens down. They'll be here when morning rolls around. Baby, it's not always an easy fix. Some seasons you'll just have to deal with, but it's not the end of the world. I am here.
I'm excited because I'm here with Ndambi. Now I just want to get the pronunciation right.
That's right.
Is it right? Oh, brilliant. So I just had to say welcome to the UK.
Thanks, Ryan.
It's been a pleasure having you here. When I was listening to your nominated Grammy Award album, Pink Elephant, and particularly Oh Baby and Can't Hardly Wait, I was like, this album is like, ta-da! You know, it's absolutely brilliant. That's the only way I can describe Pink Elephant as, ta-da! It's just like amazing.
Thank you so much.
How was the creative process for you?
Well, the creative process is each and every time I'm making an album, it's always
always challenging because you're trying to draw from new energy in a new place. Although you know about the same things, you're trying to convey a message differently. So it's always the challenge to start, and you're trying to find your footing in doing that. And then you don't want to, it's almost like you want to find ways without feeling as though you're repeating yourself. Start is always very challenging, but once I get into it, then the process kind of takes its own like road, and I just follow the path after that.
Okay. You know, I know you was brought up in a Baptist home. How has your music gone down with the family?
It's actually been received very well, and my family's very supportive, and they come to the shows, and they're very proud, and so I'm excited to represent my family really well. So.
Brilliant. And I understand you know, you've done a degree in English creative writing. Mm-hmm. You know, has that helped towards, you know, your writing ability? Because you write most, if not all, of your own music.
I think that it helps a lot. What it does for me is it allows me to have a place to get outside of myself and write in the perspective or point of view of someone else. And so with creative writing, you're always focusing on building characters and finding different places to write from. So that's one way that I get to expand in writing, by writing from that place when I write songs.
I think it's very important for, you know, especially young artists coming in, that they know, you know, education does pay. And, you know, it helps towards, you know, their career. It's not just about making the music. It's about having that backing as well.
It is. I mean, to me, going to college helps you become a well-rounded person. And I don't think you should just go to college because you're looking for a vocational education to get a degree to make a lot of money. I think you should go to expand your mind, and when you expand your mind and you learn more about who you are as a person, you can make money doing any kind of thing, but it allows you to be able to have a large palette to color from when you get that kind of education in there.
Okay, so Pink Elephant.
Yes.
How did you come up with that title for the album?
Well, Pink Elephant is always, to me, it's kind of a play on that elephant in the room. And, you know, pink being an obviously, if there were a pink elephant in a room, you would obviously see it. Very much so. Yeah. So I just wanted to play on that idea. And I think that each individual, we have that quality and that exists in each one of us. And what I mean by that is we have a certain kind of quality that shines through. And sometimes when other people see it, they don't want to talk about it. They don't want to touch it. They know it's there. Sometimes they may not even acknowledge it. But then there are those who see it and say, what about the pink elephant in the room? They do know. And what it is just saying, finding your own star, embracing it, and just doing it to the fullest, and being comfortable in your own place. And when you're comfortable with where your path and your journey is, then you walk straight, you walk really regal, you walk in confidence because you know where you're going. And then people see that and they're like, what is that? They have this air about themselves. And that's basically what I was talking about with that. And I think that that is a characteristic that every individual embodies, and I will say that I feel like that exists in me as well.
Definitely can get that vibe through Nobody Jones single, you know, exactly what you said is portrayed in that song, and Can't Hardly Wait. I just love that song. I prefer the not radio edited version than the.
Me too. It's a spunky song. It's just it was done in jest, and I didn't mean any harm when I did it. It was just more done in fun. And it's just talking about how you feel when you know you're really, really connected to someone and you really know the relationship isn't working for you. But you want to move away from that and move on to something more positive. But you haven't gotten the strength yet, but you're on your last leg. You just need one more bad thing to happen and then you're out of there.
You know, when I heard that song, I could relate to so many of my girlfriends that I think, oh, why are they still doing with this guy? And, you know, so that song really embodies that. How would you describe, how would you like people to know about Nindambi and your music and your style?
Well, I would like for people to know the music and my style as being, I create music that I want to leave that's timeless, that hopefully will be around long after I'm gone, that people can continue to tell their children about, and leaving that legacy in music. That's what I really want to do with music and that whole thing.
We can definitely see that, and all the influences, you know, that you can see through your music, using the 70s and 80s as a milestone, and actually telling a story and not just singing a song. Mm-hmm. And I find that very beautiful and very refreshing that we have artists like you that are, you know, delivering that style of music. So just to sum up, I'd just like to say thank you to Nandambi. And, you know, by Pink Elephant, it's out now. It's a Grammy nominated album, and it's my birthday next month, so I'm making sure that I get that album for my for my birthday. So yes, thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
So much. I'm
it's a dog in the park. It's the fog after dark. It's the wind in your hair. It's the kiss that you left after giving your best. It's the thought as I walk. It's like taking sips from your cup of coffee, smoking a cigarette after dinner time. It's like making love on Egyptian cotton. All in all, it will be fine.
And I'm here with the gorgeous Rashawn Patterson. Hello. I'm fine, thank you very much. I've enjoyed the show.
Thank you.
You've given the UK audience a wonderful performance here at the Shepherd's Bush O2.
Thank you.
How do you feel when you come to England?
I love it. You know, ever since my first album, when I've come to perform, you know, they give me love, so I just give it back. You know, they support what I do, and I appreciate it.
But I know this visit has coincided with the fact of your new album, Bluephoria, coming out. Can you just tell us, what does Bluephoria mean?
Bluephoria is a combination of the words bliss and euphoria, and it was the state that I found myself in, you know, after being in love and having been inspired by that relationship. Yeah.
And also, I know from doing my research, you always name the last single of any said album. Yeah. Is the prelude to the next album, and the last single on Bluephoria is God's.
Yeah.
So can you give us a little exclusive insight into what the next album's going to be, or the concept of the next album?
It'll be in the realm of what heaven probably feels like, okay. You know?
It's going to be a lot of soul searching and deep thinking.
Well, it's more of having been through the hardships and, you know, releasing the fears and becoming one with oneself and finding love and finding the God in oneself. And then from there, you know, you can do anything.
So, what, you started at a very young age, 6 years old, singing in church.
Yeah.
You know, how has that process been?
Tonight, we bring you a young man who won the big money on last year's Junior Star Search Special. He did that after beating out some very talented youngsters in an open call here in Los Angeles. He parlayed his championship into regular appearances on the series Kids Inc. Help me welcome Rashawn Patterson.
Probably from my family. you know, they always forced me to sing in church and stuff. So from there, I was able to discover that I had a gift. And, you know, anytime I sing, that's pretty much where I am at one with the universe, you know. So that's where the confidence comes from, because I allow myself to release myself from myself, you know, and let spirit move.
Very, very inspirational artist, and you know, I'm just loving where you get your inspirations from and how you put your albums together. I know you've just come off stage and I appreciate the fact that you're here speaking to us on VNOW TV. So just like to say thank you to Rashawn Patterson.
Thank you.
It's been a pleasure talking to you. And thank you very much.
Thank you.
Okay. Hi, we've just finished talking to Rashawn Patterson off stage. It's been a brilliant performance by him and the Dambi. We're at the Shepherd's Bush Empire. It's the end of the show. It's time to go home. As you can see, everyone's packing up. I've had a wonderful time here, and I hope you enjoyed listening to the Dambi and Rashawn Patterson with VNOW TV. I'm Tracy Williams, and this is the Tracy Williams Show for Rhythm 365. Thank you.